Good afternoon. 2 weeks back, I turned 44. No, I'm not under panic attack. I'm not going through midlife crisis right now. But yes, it did put me in a slightly reflective mood. And I look back at my 20-odd years and I ask myself, what is my story? What is it that I can talk about myself and perhaps inspire thoughts in even one person around me? And I realize my story is really about reinvention. What is reinvention? It's when you embrace a major change in your life, relook at the path you have taken up till now, and you change the course. It's not easy. It's actually scary. You don't know what the rules are. You don't even know if you're going to be good at it. Sometimes you have to change because, you know, life hits you. And at that point, a point of time, you're kind of at a point where you figure out, do I want to focus on this for the rest of my life, and focus on what it is stopping me from doing? Or I relook at my path and change the course completely and reinvent. And just sometimes, you also get a window into something so compelling, and you say, you know what, this is what I want to do for the rest of my life, and you change. So reinvention, sometimes it just, you have to do it, and some you choose. So my story is really about reinvention. I'll talk to you a couple of stories and hopefully inspire some thoughts, and that's what my talk is all about. So in 2000, my husband and I got the opportunity to move to Philippines for a short assignment. I had been in brand management till then, and I knew I'll not be able to work because I had no work permit. But we went with a sense of adventure. You know, you get to see a new culture, you get to immerse in it. We'll kind of travel Southeast Asia. And the fact is, we had been married for 3.5 years. It was okay, we'll take a break, plan a family, it kind of worked. And frankly, I loved being an expat, trailing spouse for all of 4 months. I loved doing stuff which I'd never had time to do before. I was painting at Ayala Museum. I finally learned how to cook. But in 4 months, I realized I'm going to drive myself mad and I'm going to make my husband absolutely insane. I met the trade counselor at the Embassy of India in a party. And I went to him, I said, you know what? Do you have any projects? I'll volunteer, I'll do it for free. Give me some work to do. He's one of the finest persons I've met. We're still friends. He's an ambassador now in an Eastern European country. And he said, come over. Next week, I met them at the embassy and they asked me to join them as trade consultant. I got such an amazing exposure on how international business is done. I met some fascinating people. One person I met, especially I remember him, very low profile person, small Gujarati man, not very articulate, not very educated, but every year there were 2 ships full of salt would come to Philippines. He would export them from Gujarat to Philippines. And I realized, it opened my mind to possibilities of what you can do, and it has nothing to do with what you have done up till now. And also I realized, if I want to work, I think this is the way I can possibly look at, this is what I can look at, doing international trade. Now you have to understand something, I'm an army kid. People around me are either army officers or air force or engineers or doctors. Business doesn't run in my family. Didn't stop me. I stepped back and I said, okay, what is it that I can do well? What do I understand? And wait, which are the top retailers of Philippines? 2 names came up, Rustan's and Landmark. In 1.5 months from them, I got my first trial order from Rustan's. What am I trying to say? A, why I volunteered? Sometimes just go for the experience. You never know what doors it opens for you. Second, always aim for best. You have to understand, retailers, top retailers get calls from exporters and traders from all over the world. Not just India, not just Pakistan, not Bangladesh, Peru, China, Hong Kong, Thailand. If you start thinking, probably it's very difficult to even make that first call. But I did that. That was my first time I reinvented myself as an entrepreneur. I'm going to move to 2006. By now, my company has become bigger. I'm now in Belgium. And I have a retailer which has 200 stores all over Europe. I was happy. And then my husband got very sick. he went through some excruciating, painful tests for 2 months, and they diagnosed him with lymph cancer. Now, I don't know if you understand this. I'm in a French country. Doctors don't speak English. I have a 2.5-year-old and I have a 4-year-old. They are babies. I have no help. I live in a French neighborhood. You know how European houses are, 3-4 stories, big yard. All that came to me. I was pedaling hard just to keep my head above water. I'd reached the limits of physical. I was just tired. Why? Because I had to take care of my husband. Yes, it was a misdiagnosis, but he was very sick for a long time. He was at home. I had to give him 4 fresh meals. No frozen stuff, no defrosted stuff, no leftovers. Fresh meals. 2 babies who were absolutely did not have any idea what your mom is going through. And a dog, which was the best part of the whole scene. And then my buyer called me. She said, Ratika, the shipment which came, one stole, one color, 3,000 pieces. There was a strange smell in it, and they have to be replaced. I realized what had happened. The bleach probably hadn't dried, and my partner had packaged it, and that smell came while it came through the ocean or cargo. That's not the part. She said, Ratika, that stole is on the top of my catalog and my posters and all 200 retail stores in Europe. I need it. I said, okay, what's the time? How much time do you have? She said, 10 days. And I realized at that time, there's no way I can get it done again and shipped again. I said, fine. You know what I did? Apart from taking care of my husband and my kids, I brought them to my house. Every morning, I would get up before everybody got up, wash 300 stoles a day, hand wash. Go through the day with the usual routine. When everybody slept, I would iron them, re-tag them, and repackage them for 10 days, 3,000 pieces packaged and given back. Why am I telling you this? Sometimes it's not about smart thinking, it's just sheer hard work. And sometimes you know that you've given your best and you still have to walk, that belief helps that I can do it. It helps you keep walking. Trust me, when you feel that you have nothing more to give, you dig deep down and you can do it. There's overwhelming, you're overwhelmed, but there is still reserve. I'll move too quickly to 2012. By now, I have moved from a trader to a manufacturer to a brand owner. I have a company in Singapore and in America. And because I had worked in 3 or 4 countries by now, I'd set up businesses. INSEAD in Singapore called me to mentor their Women in Business Club. And I loved it. For the first time, I wanted to do something for the rest of my life. I realized I love being part of the campus. I got myself enrolled in a diploma course from Cambridge International. There was a center there. I did an advanced training certification from Singapore Training Board. I took every single part-time job for a year in Singapore, be it in high school, be it in postgraduate, be it in schools, just to get my hands dirty in how to teach well. In 2013, we returned back to India, and I got the opportunity to teach in SPJIMR. I came as a visiting faculty. I really worked hard. I scored a very good feedback, and then there was a conversation, or should I join as an adjunct faculty? Shortly, I realized if I have to grow, so this is the second time I reinvented myself. I became an academician. And I realized, if I have to grow, I have to do a PhD. Now, a lot of my colleagues are here, but I'm going to say it. When I decided to do the PhD, I started sitting in some of the seminars. And I would sit, I would fake it that I'm getting it, and they would talk about confounding variables, validity, ANOVA, ANCOVA, and I would just look as if I'm understanding, but I would make notes, check what this means. At night, I would go and check. And slowly, I started building my vocabulary. Last year, I prepared very hard, and I got into a doctoral program at one of the premier institutes here. I also realized I want to be a coach because I was working so closely with so many students, I wanted to be better at it. So I became a certified coach. So this is where I am, from a corporate person to being an entrepreneur across 5 countries and to an academician. What is it that I wanted to say? Listen, we are faculty, we do PPTs, we just cannot resist it. Be passionate in whatever you do. Ideas to enjoy it, right? And if you can't figure it out, you're probably in the wrong place. But I have a feeling, even if you're not enjoying it, there's a way to start liking the process. Be passionate about it. Aim for excellence. Don't accept mediocrity. You want to be an author? Say you're going to write the bestseller. You want to be a singer? Train for the best, apply for Mahindra Blues Festival that you're going to perform there. You want to be anything, aim for the best. Belief is critical, helps you keep walking. Create bonds with people around you. I've had strangers do random acts of kindness towards me, which I couldn't pay back, but I've been paying forward. Compassion just makes the world so much better. Learnability, it's not about I know, it's about, yeah, I'll figure it out, I can learn. And the last is, which I'd mentioned earlier, sometimes just go for the experience, you never know where it takes you. So what have I in front of me? I have a pebble. Sorry. A pebble. Thanks, George, for picking that up for me. And so the last shot that I want to share before going off the stage is, you can look at life and look at what it throws at you. Now you can navigate life with difficulty with a pebble in your shoe and have an excruciating journey. Or you can be the pebble in a still pond and create ripples of change and gently touch the lives of other people. Thank you so much.